Alright, something's been bugging me, and I'm going to say it. Who are these people that say Goku was a bad father? Goku was a good father. At least he was in Z. So why do people say Goku is a bad father? Because he wasn't there. Well, let me break that down for you. Saiyan Saga. People say Piccolo was always more of a father to Gohan than Goku ever was. The first formative years of Gohan's life, Goku was there. Yeah, Goku is training, but it was obvious that he loved his son. Goku was there. So after Raditz gets killed, Piccolo kidnaps Gohan and takes him into the wilderness to train for the coming of Nappa and Vegeta. Yeah, Piccolo effectively raised Gohan for a year. Where was Goku? Oh wait, he was dead. The man was literally dead. So the Saiyans come to Earth, Goku gets wished back by the Dragon Balls, and he throws down. He comes to protect his son. Nappa's like, oh god, I can't beat this guy. You know what? I'm going to go kill his son. Goku says, oh my god, this guy is about to kill my son. I better break his spine. So everyone gangs up on Vegeta. Vegeta almost gets killed, but Goku says, no, spare him! Which turned out to be the best decision he ever made as a character, but we'll get to that later. So Vegeta flies to Namek, Krillin, Gohan, and Bulma say, we better follow him. Goku was so badly messed up by Vegeta, he was admitted to a hospital before they could give him a senzu bean. And as we saw in the anime, they didn't let him out of the hospital until long after the three of them had left for Namek. So Goku gets the capsule spaceship, he goes to Namek. He trains in 100 times Earth's gravity. He goes to Namek to protect his son. He saves his son from Raccoon. Goku fights Frieza, tells Gohan, get out of here. I don't want you to get hurt. You have to get back to Earth. Frieza dies, Namek explodes, the whole Namek arc resolves. Yeah, you can argue that Goku took his sweet fat time coming back from Yardrat. But once he was back, he was there. Trunks Saga to Android Saga. 3-year time skip. Goku was training with Gohan, making him stronger, because these guys were coming, and they meant business. And boy, did they. So they finally fight the androids. Goku's incapacitated, wasn't around for a little bit. Why was that? He had a heart attack that future Trunks was able to save him from because he gave him medicine that didn't exist in that time. So the androids are there. They start wreaking havoc. Oh god, now we have to deal with Cell. What do we do? Goku says, I'm taking my son with me. We're going into the hyperbolic time chamber, and we're training for a year. He trained his son. And numerous times, you could see how proud he was of his child and the potential that he displayed. Goku was there. And then the fight against Cell. Goku gives up because he says, no, I have faith in my son. My son can do this. He is my son. He's going to mop the floors with you. Yeah, there was a little stressful moment there, but Gohan did it. Now here's the big one. Here's the one that people always love to point at. Goku died and didn't come back from the dead. Why did he do what he did? I'll tell you why, but put yourself in his shoes. Think about all these people. Frieza, King Cold, Dr. Gero, Android 17, Android 18, Android 16, Cell, that other guy, Perfect Cell. All of these people, what did they all come about for? Kill Goku. Priority one, kill Goku. They came here just to kill me. All of these guys came here, threatened all of you, and threatened the whole planet just to say, I hate you, Goku. I'm not doing that anymore. If I stay away, and if these villainous powers know that I'm no longer here, maybe they'll leave you guys alone. Goku stays dead for a very long amount of time because he believes in his pure heart that is the best way to protect his family, Chi-Chi and Gohan. And then Buu Saga, what happens? Fortune teller Baba comes and says, hey, wanna come back to Earth for a day? Meet your new son? And Goku's like, I have a second son one day and I get to compete in the martial arts tournament again? I am in. He comes, meets his son, and he's proud of both of them. And what does he have to do? He has to clean up the mess that Gohan and Vegeta made. What's Vegeta doing during this whole time to his son? Oh yeah, that's right. Other than sparring matches, did Goku ever do something like that? No. Yeah, you could say when that's this whole Goku might not be the best father thing started to come out. But that's Buu Saga. I have my fair share of problems with Buu Saga. But that's a rant for another time. But that is a concept we call Flanderization. Basically, it's when you take a small idiosyncrasy of a character and turn it up to 11 until it becomes their character. Case in point, the religious fanaticism of Ned Flanders in The Simpsons. It's where the name comes from. Don't believe me? Google it. It's on TV Tropes. Goku has been flanderized to be a bad father because people are jumping on the Team 4-Star bandwagon. Now look, I love Team 4-Star. Big fan of their work. If you guys can make sure they see this, please by all means. The flanderization is played for laughs. Oh my god, did they really just say that? But no. In Z, Goku was a good father. Yes, he wanted to protect the Earth, but when he was protecting the Earth, his son was there with him, and he was with his son almost whenever was sanely possible. Goku was a good father. Fight me.